Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe. And today I'm going to show you how to add a water splash to a photo to really make a splash. Okay, you know, bad pun, okay. But when it comes to a photograph and getting people's attention, nothing does it like a big, huge water splash or multitude of water splashes. For example, have a look at this cover here that I did for an article in Photoshop User Magazine recently. And you can see how the water splash is what really adds the drama and the life to this photograph. So I'm going to reproduce this right now using some photos that I've grabbed from Adobe Stock. Now, by the way, Adobe Stock is a great place to get photos and textures and brushes and different things like that. In fact, we're going to be using it today. If you want to try it out, grab 10 free images from the link underneath. Here we've got a girl and just kind of cut her out on the background here. And we're going to add some water splash. I'm also going to show you how to clean up that selection, get rid of that black fringe in a second. That's a bonus tip. So the first thing we want to do, though, is look at the water splashes. How are we going to do water splashes? Well, what we want to do is we just want to search for splash. Notice how I just type right there inside the library there. And we can see all these different splashes come up. So these are different photographs of splashes. Now, I'm going to do a tutorial next week, so tune in, where I'm going to show you how to extract semi-transparent things like water and smoke. Until then, what we're going to do today is we're going to use a brush. So what we've done is we've found some water here, and I can click on it there to download it. You'll notice that the little check mark appears. That means I've previously licensed it. And what I want to do is just show you how this works. So we just double click to open this water here. And then to make a brush, all we need to do is we just make a selection around that water that we want to make a brush out of. Let's grab this one here. And then I'm just going to hit Control L for levels. Now what I want to do is I just want to really darken down the darks and lighten up the lights and just kind of move around so we get a good, clearly defined subject. And that's looking pretty good. So I'm going to click OK. And then all we need to do here is just simply go to Edit, Define Brush Preset. And we're just going to call it Splash. Click OK. And now you can see there's the brush. See that? That's the preset. Let me just turn off the selection. And if I click anywhere with this, you can see that now I'm able to paint with this water splash. Now the other two I've already turned into brushes. So let's have a look at how we can use these brushes now inside of Photoshop. So let's go to our shot. And notice one of the things, notice there's a black outline around there. See that black outline? I'm going to show you a little tip for getting rid of that. All we simply need to do is select the layer. Notice there's no mask, it's just the cutout area. And then we're going to go to Layer. Under Layer, you'll see an option that says Matting. And now I can remove a black or a white mat. I'm going to remove a black mat. And notice how immediately we get a nice clean edge. Now just remember, you can't do that if you're selected on a mask. You have to actually have it cut out, and then you can do that matting. So it's useful in a situation like that. All right, so now that we've got a cleaner background, let's add some water. So we're going to create a layer on top. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to call this Splash. And we know we've just created a water splash because we just saw that brush previously. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose the X key to make sure I'm using white as my foreground color. Now I'm going to grab the B for the brush tool. And notice there's our splash, that's our brush. Now it's a little large, so I'm just going to hit the left bracket key and make it smaller. And notice we can see what it looks like right there. So if we wanted to put a little splash like maybe around the knee, I could just click there and apply that splash around the knee. Now I can move this around and do some different things with it. Now that's not bad there, but I might want to mask it. So we're just going to grab a mask there, and I'm just going to grab B, and then we're just going to grab our regular brush, and now we can just kind of fine tune this. So let me just zoom in a little bit, and we can just paint this away. Notice what I'm doing is I'm using a black brush. So if I want a softer edge, pull the hardness all the way down here, and I can just kind of sort of paint that in a little bit so we're getting more of a splash that's coming out of where she would be hitting on the ground. Now, if I really wanted to make this look more realistic with water and stuff, I could put a reflection of her. You could do all those kinds of things. But what I want to focus on today is the splashes. And now you've seen these also, you know, where they apply color and do different types of things to these. But let's just make it a water splash. So we're just going to zoom out. That's just hitting Control Zero. We want to add a few more. So I'm going to create a new layer and we're going to grab the B for brush. And let's go down to some of the other ones that I grabbed earlier on. So let's find one of these. I'm thinking, you know, this one here looks pretty neat. It's a pretty dynamic looking brush. So let me just click around there. That's going to look quite nice. So I'm just going to click there. And notice now we've got more of a splash just kind of coming up. Now, if we wanted, we could put it behind her just by dragging it down in the layers panel. And notice that now we've got that kind of splash. We can reposition it where it's coming up behind her. And that's looking pretty cool. I'm liking that a lot. So just remember that when you're working with these water splashes, there are different things we can do like this. We can reposition them, we can resize them, we can cut pieces off. And really, that is the key. Let me create a new layer now, and we're going to grab another one. The key to making this really work is to just start manipulating these splashes in different ways. So here's one there. And right now, I'm not sure how that would work. In fact, you know what? I'm looking for something that's going to wrap. See how it kind of a wrap around her body? If we go to about there, we get this kind of wraparound effect. See that? And maybe there. So we can apply that. Let's drag it above her and see what it looks like. So see how we've got that kind of wraparound effect that we can do there. Now you want to kind of mask this out a little bit. Let's bring it to about there, kind of looks good. And let's create a mask. Grab the brush. Go back to our regular brush here to just kind of mask this out. And I don't want any of this in front of her. I just want it kind of going around behind. So we could kind of do that. And maybe that's a little much there. You can kind of just play around there and get that water to just kind of lap around. Maybe we want it behind her arm there. There we go. And you get the general idea. So we're starting to do that. Maybe we want to do a little bit more. Let's add a little bit more fun on here. So let's go in here. We're going to grab the brushes again, B key. And you know, we've got different types here. What's this one here look like? Okay, this one's just a simple splash, which looks good. Notice I just applied it there. And what I'm going to do is hit Control T for free transform. And I'm just going to flip this one around and just move it. And I'm going to scale this down. I'm holding down the shift key to constrain it. And notice we could go up here if we just wanted to have a little bit there, or maybe some coming off behind her hands or through her hands. Notice we can do this kind of thing right there. And if you didn't want that there, you just want to kind of wanted it behind her, we could drag that underneath and maybe even make it smaller. And see how I'm just manipulating this and just kind of getting it where I want it. Now, I could just copy this. I'm just holding the Alt key or the Option key and dragging out over here. And if I wanted to create, you know, little splashes coming out over here, we could do this. Maybe down there. So we've got more splashes coming out behind her leg. Hit the Alt or the Option key once again, duplicate it. And notice what I'm doing. I'm just moving this one around and reusing this just to kind of get some splashes going in some of these different areas. I'm going to reproduce it there as well. And we're starting to get a little bit more interest going on here, creating this cool effect. Now, there's other things we can do with this. Let me grab the brush and we could go down here where we've got some bubbles kind of going on here. You know, it could be kind of fun just to create little splashes coming off like that. See that? A little bit big though. So let's make these smaller. So we got some splashes coming off there, some there, definitely some coming off the hair. And another thing you can do too is you can rotate this using the brush. So if we go into the brushes panel here under the brush settings, we can actually go here and we can change the direction by just moving that around. And now see how we're getting some slightly different things going on with these bubbles over here now. Let's change the angle to there. And then what we're doing is we're literally getting this water splashing off the hair using the same splash that by changing the direction, it looks like we've got more kind of water going on there. So anyway, guys, I'm curious, have you ever used brushes before like this? Answer me yes or no in the comments. And have you ever, like, you know, just taken a photograph and you can turn it into a brush that can reuse it? So right now I'm showing water, but this works for a number of different things. So anyway, when you play around with these kind of brushes, you can make some really interesting compositions. Now, if these compositions are based on your own photographs, you can submit them to Adobe Stock, get them in front of millions of people, and make some extra revenue. If you want to become a contributor, look at the link underneath where you can join up and become a contributor on Adobe Stock. And also, if you want to grab some images to play around with, there's a link down there too that'll give you 10 free images. So anyway, guys, smash that like button into dust. And let me know in the comments, are you excited about the semi-transparent selections that we're going to be doing next week? It's going to be a fun tutorial. And until then, I'll see you at the cafe.